So in this lecture we begin chapter 3. In this chapter we will discuss various continuous probability distributions. First see the definition of continuous random variable. A continuous random variable is a variable x that takes all values x in an interval or intervals of real numbers. And its probability for a particular value is zero. So in case of discrete random variable, the values taken by x are discrete, separate values. But in this case, x takes continuous values in an interval, okay? And probability for a particular value of x is zero by definition. See this example. If x denotes the lifetime of a person, then it is a continuous random variable because lifetime happens over a continuous period of time, no matter how small or big it is. Lifetime is something continuous. Okay? So continuous random variable takes values in an interval. Next, probability density function. Recall the definition of probability mass function in case of discrete random variable. It is just parallel to that definition. A function f is called probability density function or PDF of a continuous random variable x provided fx is non-negative for all x. Probability of x in an interval is given by integral of fx from a to b. Probability of x in the interval a to b is given by integral of fx from a to b. And integral of fx over the whole range of x, maximum possible range of x is minus infinity to infinity when x is a real number. So integral over the whole range of x is 1. What happens in case of discrete? Fx greater than or equal to 0. Probability for any particular value of x is given by fx and sum of all values of fx is 1. So what is the difference? See that second condition. Okay, you can call it second, it is third. What is second condition? Probability of x in the interval. Here probability for a particular value of x is given by fx. Here the probability of x is given in an interval by this integral. Okay, that is the difference. And third condition, summation has gone to integral sign in case of continuous random variable. So it's easy to remember this definition. Next, cumulative distribution function. What is CDF in case of discrete? Sum of probabilities up to x less than or equal to x. This is the definition of CDF and you denote it by fx. What do you think? What is the definition or what should be the definition in case of continuous random variable? Sum of probabilities of up to x. So instead of summation sign, now it is integral sign. Minus infinity to x, fx dx. Expectation and moment generating function. What should be expectation? Recall the discrete case. Expectation of x is given by summation x fx. In case of continuous, it should be integral x fx dx. Moment generating function, in case of discrete, it is expectation of e power tx. And it is solved by summation, but in case of continuous case, minus infinity to infinity e power tx fx dx. Expectation of general function of x. So you can understand these definitions from the discrete case. What has happened? The summation sign has gone to integral sign. Moments, mean and variance, these definitions also you can understand easily. Expect kth moment is given by expectation of x power k. So in the continuous, in the discrete case you use summation, here you need to use the integral sign. Okay, mean, expectation of x, variance, ex square minus ex whole square. So everywhere that summation sign is changed to integral sign. Now further, the condition integral fx minus infinity to infinity dx is 1. What does it mean? Because now it is continuous function, you can draw its graph in xy plane. So what is the meaning of this condition? Area under this curve, because now fx is a continuous function, you can plot it, say its curve goes like this. So total area under this probability curve is 1. Total area minus infinity to infinity, or whatever range of x is given to you, this is 1. So what is the meaning of this one in terms of probability of x? This is probability of x lying in the range a to b, lying in the interval a to b. So here it means area under the probability curve from x equal to a to x equal to b. Okay, this you can also write as, using the property of integrals, you can write it integral of fx from minus infinity to b minus minus infinity to a. But in this format, when this integral is in this format, this is nothing but capital ABCDF, probability of x up to b, and this is probability of x up to a. So capital FB minus capital FA. Thing is that you can write the probability in terms of CDF. This is very useful property. You will use it in some distribution further. Because it is continuous random variable, it doesn't matter whether you include the endpoints or not. Probability for a particular value of x is 0, you know it. So you are finding in an open interval or semi-open interval, it doesn't matter, probability remains the same in all cases. You write equal to sign or not, it doesn't matter. Next, from the property of integrals, you know that capital F prime x should be small fx. What is capital F prime x, or capital fx first? Minus infinity to x fx dx. So if I differentiate it with respect to x, it should be fx only, using first fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, this is a standard result, but of course f prime x should exist for this result. So these are some useful properties that you need to notice. Now let's see this example. Verify whether this function fx equal to this is density function of x. How to verify? If it is density function, its integral over the whole range of x should be 1. This is one property of the density function. Of course it is non-negative, it provides probabilities in given interval of x, but what you need to verify here, that integral of this function over the given range of x is 1. Means what is the given range here? 0.1 to 0.5. minus infinity to infinity, but outside range less than 0.1 or greater than 0.5, the function is zero. So no need to write that, just solve this integral. Fx is given to here. If you are getting 1, it's density function. Yes, you get 1. Next, you need probability of x in this range. So just integrate the function from 0.2 to 0.3. You can verify this answer yourself. Likewise, you can find mean, variance and capital Fx. How to find mean? Mean means expectation of x. For continuous random variable, it is x fx dx. And in this case, range of x is 0.1 to 0.5. So just substitute this expression of fx here, multiply by x and integrate. You will get this answer 0.3667. Likewise, you can find ex square further. Multiply fx by x square and integrate over the same range. And then you can use the formula sigma square equal to ex square minus ex whole square. Okay, to get variance. So you can verify these answers yourself. It's a matter of calculation only. How to find capital Fx? Capital Fx means minus infinity to x fx dx. So its calculation depends on x, where x lies. So from the definition of fx, it is clear that when x is less than 0.1, it's 0. That's why its first branch is 0. Second one, when x lies in this range, 0.1 to 0.5, then you have to use this expression for fx in the integral. Means for that range you will solve it 0.1 to x fx dx, where x lies in the range 0.1 to 0.5. okay, so whatever you get, write that thing here. So in fact you will get this expression when you integrate from 0.1 to x. And then for greater than 0.5, of course its value should be 1, because after that nothing is left. For x greater than 0.5, small fx is 0, so no contribution will be coming after this. So for x greater than 0.5, if you integrate, you will get 1. Okay, x greater than 0.5 means starting from the lowest value, or you can say 0.1 to 0.5, because less than 0.1 it's 0, small fx is 0. So if you integrate small fx from 0.1 to 0.5, you will get 1. Next, uniform distribution. Do you recall uniform distribution in case of discrete random variable? A discrete random variable has uniform distribution if it has same probabilities for each value of x. It's similar to that. The difference is here that the random variable takes values in an interval or on a continuous scale. So a continuous random variable x is said to have uniform distribution if its density function is given by 1 over b minus a, when x lies in the interval a to b, elsewhere it is 0. With this definition of PDF, x is said to have uniform distribution. You can see in this interval, it's independent of it, it's constant. So this is PDF of uniform distribution. For uniform distribution, you can do these calculations yourself using the definitions of CDF, movement generating function, mean and variance. PDF is given here. Follow the same way that you have followed in this example. Do the calculations, you will find these expressions in case of uniform distribution. Okay, so I have nothing to explain here. You can do it yourself. See this example now. Suppose that a large conference room at a certain company can be reserved for no more than 4 hours. Both long and short conferences occur quite often. Assume that the length x of a conference has a uniform distribution on the interval 0 to 4. What is the probability density function? Interval 0 to 4. So what is PDF? Here A is 0, B is 4. So PDF should be 1 over B minus A, 1 over 4, when X lies in the interval 0, 4, elsewhere it is 0. Correct? What is the probability that any given conference lasts at least 3 hours? At least 3 hours means it requires probability X greater than equal to 3. So it should be integral from 3 to infinity. But you know after 4 its value is 0. So just write 3 to 4 fx dx. And what is fx? 1 by 4 dx. Just simplify this integral. You will get 1 over 4. Okay. Next is a very, very important distribution called normal or Gaussian distribution. It's of real practical importance. See what is its PDF. A continuous random variable x is said to follow normal distribution with parameters mu and sigma if its density function is given by this function or this expression. What is it? 1 over sigma root 2 pi e power minus half x minus mu over sigma whole square. X and mu could be any real numbers, but sigma is always positive. In fact, mu is mean of fx here and sigma is standard deviation. This can be proved using the definitions of mu and sigma. And using this PDF, okay. What is special about it? Why is it called normal? Gaussian, of course, was discovered by the mathematician Gauss. Normal, I will explain, but before that, let's see its properties. For the normal random variable x, of course, the integral of fx from minus infinity to infinity is 1. It can be shown mathematically by integrating this from minus infinity to infinity. See the lecture notes, detailed calculations are given there. And likewise, it can be shown that its moment generating function is given by e power mu t plus half sigma square t square. This is the graph of this PDF. It is bell-shaped curve. Where is the highest value or the largest value? At x equal to mu, the value is 1 over sigma root 2 pi that we are seeing here. At x equal to mu, the value is largest. So it's bell-shaped curve. Total area under this curve is 1. This probability curve is normal probability curve. Now see why is it normal. Let me explain you through an example. Say this side you have income and this side number of persons. number of persons in India. Let's talk about India. So what should be the graph look like in normal situation? This side, who are the persons, and this side, who are the persons? Can you tell me? Birla, Ambanis, Tatas, etc. You know, very rich people, but the number is less. This side, very poor people, you understand, unknown people which are very poor. What is this major portion? You can call it, this portion belongs to middle class. So in normal situation, what happens? There are poor people. In normal situation, there are poor people, there are rich people, but they are almost same. Okay, there are not many rich people, there are not many poor people. A larger portion is constituted by middle class. This is normal situation. What is abnormal? If it goes like this, what does it mean? A majority is of poor people. Okay, if this is the situation, then majority is rich people. Okay, so this is the normal situation. So in almost all the practical phenomena, when data are collected, a normal pattern is found. Even when you appear in the exam and a histogram of the marks is created, in normal situation the graph goes like this. If this side I write marks, this side number of students, this is normal histogram. Okay, so this side very few students, this side also very few students. Here is the average of marks, so you understand it's normal distribution of marks. What is abnormal? If it goes like this, this is abnormal situation. So you understand the word normal here now. So if it is perfectly bell shaped around the middle value, it's normal distribution. Mean can be proved equal to mu variance sigma square. If x is a normal random variable with mean mu and variance sigma square, then we write this notation. X follows normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma square. A shortcut notation for this statement. This is very important. What is standard normal variate or variable? Z equal to x minus mu over sigma. The new variable defined by x minus mu over sigma. This is called standard normal variable. You can determine its expectation easily. What is expectation? 1 over sigma is constant, so Ex minus mu. Mu is also constant. Ex is mu, mu minus mu 0. Likewise, you can check variance is 1. So standard normal variable mean is 0, variance is 1. Okay, so Z follows normal distribution with mean 0, variance 1, and its density of course becomes this. It is given a new notation, phi Z. So you can check with this formula. Mu is 0, variance 1. So because sigma is 1, so 1 over root 2 pi, and this has gone to Z. So this is the expression. All right. This is the graph of phi Z. So Z equal to 0 belongs to X equal to mu. Z equal to 1 belongs to mu minus sigma. Mu plus sigma or mu minus sigma. See, this is the normal distribution plot, normal probability curve plot. Z equal to 0 or write x equal to mu, both are same. because z equal to x minus mu over sigma. Now what if z equal to or x equal to, this corresponds to, okay, x equal to mu if I write z equal to 0. What if I write x equal to mu plus sigma? What is it? Mu plus sigma, mu cancel, z is 1. So this corresponds to z equal to 1. Alright. So z equal to 1 means x equal to mu plus sigma. Likewise, z equal to minus 1 means x equal to mu minus sigma. So you can write normal distribution in terms of standard normal variable. CDF of the standard normal variable z is given by the integral from minus infinity to z, because now the variable is z and your PDF is phi z. So this is capital phi notation. Why is it important? Because the normal distribution table that you will use for writing probabilities in case of normal distribution, that is given in terms of phi z. In fact, I will use the notation capital F as we are using earlier. Okay, so capital F z means probability up to z, wherever is z. Suppose this is z. So up to z means this one. This is capital F z, or you can write capital phi z. You can also write it in terms of difference of the CDF, which probability of z in the interval a to b, capital FB minus capital FA. So these are useful formulas when you are dealing with the problems related to normal distribution. Okay. Why it is FP minus FA? Try to understand. You need probability from X, Z equal to A to B. So this is the probability from minus infinity to A is what? FA. And probability from minus infinity to B is FB. You need this one, middle one. So difference of these two, FB minus FA. This is how the normal distribution table looks that we'll use for writing probabilities in case of normal distribution. This is given in terms of standard normal variable, the values of capital FZ or phi Z. So how this table is given, see it. Z minus 3.4 corresponding to 0, 0 means first column 0, 0 means it is the value. Let me write here. If I need capital F minus 3.4, what is it? 0.0003. What if I need minus 3.41? 41 means this one, you will see. Okay. Means it is again this one, there is not much difference. The difference occurs after some decimals. So if I ask you what is this value, 0.9997, it is the value of 3.39.997. Why the value of capital F0 is 0.5? Why it is 0.5? Can you understand? Z equal to 0 corresponds to the central value. Total area under the normal probability curve is 1, and it is symmetric about this line Z equal to 0. So this side, how much area? 0.5. This side also 0.5. That's why it corresponds to the value 0.5. Okay, so you can easily use the normal probability table. Now, What is the probability of x lying in the interval mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma? Mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. Always convert x into standard normal variable for writing the probability. So what is the relation between z and x? X is z is x minus mu over sigma. That means probability of x in this interval mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. When x is mu minus sigma, z is minus 1. When x is mu plus sigma, it is plus 1. Already I have shown you earlier. So this can be written as f1 minus f minus 1. These values you can see from the normal probability table. Okay, from the table you will see these values. And finally, the required probability is 0.6826. Means there is 68.26% probability that the normal variable x lies in the interval mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. In fact, this is called 1 sigma confidence interval. This is very important term, confidence interval. So what is 1 sigma confidence interval? Mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. So the probability of x lying in this interval, or possibility of x lying in this interval, is 68.26%. There are around 68% chances that x lies in this interval. So this is 1 sigma confidence interval. Likewise, probability of x lying in the 2 sigma confidence interval is 0.9544. In 3 sigma, 0.9773. So these are some standard probabilities that are used in the problems. So you should know the meaning of 1 sigma, 2 sigma and 3 sigma confidence intervals. So what are these? 1 sigma confidence interval means mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. Okay. This interval. Mu minus 2 sigma means mu minus 2 sigma here and mu plus 2 sigma here. So mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma is 2 sigma confidence interval. So probability of x lying in this range is 0.9544. In 3 sigma, you see almost the whole probability is covered. Total probability is 1. So if you go up to 3 sigma, very negligible part is left on either side. That's why this table is given up to minus 3.4 only. Okay, because you see the values are not even changing. So if you go up beyond minus 3.4, means to the left of minus 3.4 or to the right of 3.4, the values of probability will not change much because almost whole area is covered. So in this graph you can see 1 sigma confidence interval, the shaded region shows the probability percentage, or you can say this is the area under this curve, 0.6826. This is the area under the probability curve, this golden area, for the 2 sigma confidence interval. In terms of z, you can say from minus 2 to 2. This is 3 sigma. You see almost the whole area is covered. 3 sigma confidence interval. Very little area is left on the right or left. Okay. Now let's see some problems on normal distribution. A random variable x is normally distributed with mean 9 and standard deviation 3. Mean 9 and standard deviation 3. Means mu is 9, sigma is 3. Okay, so standard normal variable in this case is x minus 9 over 3. find probability of x less than equal to 15. So what is the first task that you need to do? Change x in terms of z. X in terms of z. So what is it in terms of z? You can do the calculation yourself. X less than equal to 5 means z less than equal to 2. How? Just put x equal to 15 here, not 5, it's 15. 15 minus 9 over 3. How much it is? 2. Probability z less than equal to 2. What is probability z less than equal to 2? It's F2. Probability up to 2. That you can see from the normal distribution table. So that value is 0.9772. Probability x greater than or equal to 15 means probability z greater than or equal to 2. That you can write 1 minus probability z less than or equal to 2. Why is it done 1 minus? Because you would like to write your probability in terms of capital F. Capital F, probability up to 2. Okay, that's why it is done 1 minus, so that you can see this value from the table. Okay, probability of x from 0 to 9, first change it in terms of z. In terms of z, it goes from minus 3 to 0. That you can write f0 minus f minus 3. f0 is well known, 0.5. f minus 3 you can see from the table. And you can get this answer easily. This is a good problem. Read and try to understand it. In a normal distribution, 12% of the items are under 30, 85% are under 60. Find the mean and standard deviation of the distribution. 12% of the items are under 30. What does it mean? Under 30 means probability x less than or equal to 30 is 0.12. And 85% are under 60, probability x less than or equal to 60 is 0.85. So if you look at the normal distribution, this is given to you. X less than or equal to 30. This area is given to you as 0.12, less than 60, say 60 lies here. This whole area is given as 0.85. Okay. Now the question is to find mu and sigma. Mu and sigma are not given to you. These are not given to you. So how can you do this problem? Suppose x equal to 30 corresponds to z equal to z1. That you can check from the normal table. Probability x less than or equal to 30 means probability z less than or equal to z1. Likewise, suppose x equal to 60 corresponds to z equal to z2. So z1 and z2 you can see from the normal table, because capital FZ1 is given as 0.12. Capital FZ1 is given as 0.12. So this you can see from the normal table, that for what value of z, capital F is 0.12. Likewise, capital FZ2 is how much? 0.85. If x equal to 60 corresponds to 0.85 or z2. Okay, these values you can directly see from the normal probability table. What are these values? Minus 0.17, minus 0.1, 0.17, and other value is 1.04. these you will see from the normal distribution table. So when Z1 and Z2 are available, then you can write this relation again corresponding to x equal to 30 and x equal to 60. Because when Z is Z1, x is 30, mu is unknown, sigma is unknown, but this value I have found as minus 1.17. Likewise, the other relation. So you have two equations in mu and sigma. You can simplify these to get these values of mu and sigma. Okay. This example is similar to the previous one. What is it? Given a normal distribution with mu equal to 40, sigma equal to 6, find the value of x that has 45% of the area to the left and 14% to the right. So we require in the first part, what is required? Value of x that has 45% of the area to the left. Now see this solution. We require a z value that leaves an area 0.45 to the left. So from the normal table we find that probability of z less than minus 0.13 is 0.45. So x in terms of z is what? Sigma z plus mu. So x is sigma z plus mu. Sigma and mu are given in the problem. Z you have seen here. So use these values and do this calculation. Same way you can do the other part. Okay. When 0.86, how much area is there? To the right, 0.14. So to the left, how much? 0.86. So that you can use capital FZ again. All right. So this is a simple problem that you can understand and do yourself. So today we have done some very important discussions. The definitions related to continuous random variable. Then we have learned two important distributions. One is uniform distribution, looks simple but very useful. And other is normal distribution or Gaussian distribution. Okay. So be ready with these. In the next lecture, we will continue this discussion. Thank you.